It's a sort of My Logical Family, the original title of this memoir, was a sort of pun because it was a way of saying you have a logical family, you have a biological family, but you also have a logical family, meaning the family that makes sense for you. Many people, especially today, find that their biological family just don't understand who they are. So we choose people around us to be our family. It's not called that in French because it's sort of a jeu de mots. It's kind of difficult to explain. So it's called Mon Autre Famille, which sort of makes me sound like a bigamist. But I think it's the best title for here. I am very much afraid of what might happen in Trump's America. I try not to be afraid every day because then I would be afraid all the time. Everyone I know is deeply distressed by this man, by this frightening, stupid, cruel, ugly man. I'm just hoping for the best. There's a new series of Tales of the City beginning on Netflix next year. We're going to be shooting it in a couple of months. It's a brand new story that starts now with new storylines, nothing I've ever written before, but my characters and new adventures. And some of the actors in the original series are coming back. Laura Linney is coming back as Marianne Singleton. The character is 53 years old now. Mrs. Madrigal, the landlady, is going to be there. She's 90. Several people from the old series are going to be there. But it's a way to follow modern America and how, for instance, San Francisco is reacting to the presence of Donald Trump. And the serious division between rich and poor, the loss of the middle class in America. We have a wonderful team of writers, and I've spoken to all of them. Our head writer was the woman who wrote Orange is the New Black, and she's very sensitive to the material. She promised me that she was going to maintain the DNA of my characters, and I thought that was a good way to put it. She understood their spirit, and she wouldn't have them do things that she didn't think they could do. And I'll have a chance to pass on everything that gets written.